With all this wonderful Linux distributions and things out there that you can use to come over from Mac or Windows, it's always that reservation for a lot of us where we make the jump and our software's not going to be there, or what we do when we're on Mac or what we do when we're on Windows isn't going to be there. Now, it's not so bad, I suppose, for programming and things like that, because those languages are Linux. Most of that stuff exists across all three platforms, but certain things don't. There's no Adobe on Linux. You know, there's no Photoshop. There's certain things that aren't there. You know, for the musician guys, I mean, you've got Ableton's not on there, but you've got Bitwig, which is pretty good. Things like that. So if you're coming from that sort of area, it's a bit tricky. And if it's your livelihood, it's a really big step, isn't it? So what I thought I'd do today, I'd sort of show you, I mean, I just can't afford commercials for on Resolve, on Linux, to go out, and they've gone through QC, so that's worked. So I thought I'd show you how to do like a proper job. I mean, you can make YouTube videos in Caden Live and stuff like this, but there's no like rules around those videos. As long as your audio works and your pitch is okay, then you could have, big black apps and no one would care, would they? But when you send off proper work for commercials or for broadcast, it's got to adhere to certain standards. So can you meet those standards within, say, DaVinci Resolve? Now, this is an interesting thing. DaVinci Resolve has been on Linux for years, but for, unless you had the £30,000 version with the gigantic panels, you couldn't render ProRes. Now you can, and ProRes is the deliverable format we need for broadcast. So what I thought I'd do, I'd take you through how to line up a television commercial for broadcast in DaVinci Resolve on Omarchy. And then if you ever have to do this, totally random and bizarre, isn't it? If you ever have to do this, or you know, people say you can't do professional work on this kind of thing, well, you can. Anyway, so there you go, the preamble over, let's dive in. So, okay, so I'm on my desktop, and I've got DaVinci Resolve, or the studio version. If you have a look on this link above, there's a script, install script that will put DaVinci Resolve on Omarchy really easily. And if you look at my channel, if you're not on Omarchy, I think I've written a script for every Linux distribution I can think of to get DaVinci Resolve onto it. So it's there, so there's no excuses. The studio version, though, needs a license. Now, I had to talk to Blackmagic support to get this. There's a folder hidden away in here that you have to change chmod 7777 to allow the license key to write, or else you get a weird error. It's on the Omarchy install video for DaVinci Resolve. The line's in there. So if you do that, then you put your license key in, then you know you can get it working. Okay, so I've removed Docker. I don't even know what Docker does, and I don't need to know what Docker does. Sounds very interesting. Anyway, I've removed Docker. So I've mapped it to Super Shift D will launch Resolve for me. Now in the 3.1 update, it's gonna allow me, and I've already done a timeline-y type of thing here. We'll get to that in a second. Under that screen, I can now press Super F and I can go full screen, so I've got the whole thing. Anyway, okay, so if you don't know about Resolve, I mean, this is going to be a jump. If you do know about Resolve, you know what these areas are. There's the media pool, then you've got the quick edit bit, and then you've got the main timeline. Okay, so how do we construct a commercial? Now, what we're going to do is make a 20-second broadcast commercial for UK. And basically, the very first thing you need to do before you do anything is create your timeline. Now, you have to do this in a very specific way. So let me just go here. We'll go timeline, create new. And this bit is of huge importance. Click off that. You need to put your start time, and I can never remember it. It is 09:59:50:00. Tab. Oh, it's not done it. Okay, bear with me. So 09:59:50:00 tab. Okay, all UK broadcast commercials start from then, because the picture starts on like 10, hour 10. There's a reason for this to do with film. And then you just go through and make sure you're set up correctly. So we're doing it in HD there. Now, there's two ways to do this. You can enable interlace processing now or interlace it on the way out, but you need, irrespective of the fact that it's not broadcast interlaced, it needs to have a flag set in the file to tell it that it's interlaced. So you can either make that go, you can interlace now, or do 25, but don't forget to hit the interlace on the way out. So you just go through there, monitor, don't worry about that. Output, don't worry about that. Color, now you can set gamma 2.4, or you can set, it's just easy, not that one, you can set Rec 709 2.4, you can just set Rec 709A, and that will be the same thing. And then that will create a timeline ready to go for your commercial. Okay, so what I probably need to do actually is move myself from the bottom. Let's go back to that, and let's just move myself up here so I'm not skewing everything and come back. Okay, so hopefully I'm not skewing too much. Right, so this is the lineup. I've done it already for you, so you can see it. And there's very specific timings. For a 20-second commercial, it's going to be, and I'll bring up this, time code is your friend. Viewer, where is it? Time code window. There we go, big, beautiful time code window. So we've started on here, click on the timeline. There's our start point. And the commercial, if it's a 20-second commercial, it's going to be 40 seconds long. Sorry, it's 50, isn't it? Because it starts 10 back. So it's 50 seconds in total length, but it ends on 10:40. So just go back to the beginning. And the first thing you need on any commercial to identify it to whoever it's going to, the broadcaster, is a clock. Now, what they've done is it's called a lazy delivery, where you have 7 seconds of clock, 3 seconds of black. And so your clock counts down. I've put markers on a timeline. There it goes to 7 seconds. So as the hand ticks over, however you've done it, and then you go to 3 seconds of black, and then on 10, picture starts. So I put markers in here so you can see it. But you've got to have information on your clock. Okay, so normal information on the clock is picture, you know, the clock, your address, whatever, whoever you are. And then there's a load of text. Let me just enable this. I'll just take you through it quickly. So Omarchy release 3. So that's the product, that's the sub-product. Then there's a, this is immensely important. And if you get it wrong, it's called the clock number. It's how the media agencies use it to put it into the broadcast system. If you don't get that right, it's not going anywhere. And it's always in this format, three alphanumeric letters. Then you've got this, 3-4 code. Then you have a 0 and then you have a 2. So you have it always. So if you ever get to have to do this for a job, and you get sent that code, copy and paste it, never touch it, never change its format. It has to have slashes, has to be correct, or it ends. Then you get, it's a 20-second television commercial, it's in stereo, and there's a date. I've put any of date in, but I normally put in the date I made them. And this is I haven't made a commercial for Omarchy, but I just copy and pasted the last one I did. I made that last week or something. So that's it. And that's your clock done. And it just sits there and there. And then you get to 10, which is your picture start. So all I've used, there's a load of clip art or whatever. Hopefully this is going to play the audio over the top. Oh, move the marker. I shouldn't have done that. Let's put that back there for you. So let me just double check. I'm not feeding that into the... No, I'm not. You don't want to be hearing this over the top of me. So yeah, so your audio sits at the bottom. So anyway, so we're back at 10, picture start. And then your picture ends at 20. Right, it may not end, but what happens is all movement ends at 20 seconds. Because say I put sample in there, let's put like product, I don't know, whatever, this is your card at the end that says buy the stuff. And then at 20, you have to do what's called freeze and hold, which then goes all the way out to 30 seconds. So you have 10 seconds of freeze and hold. And then you have 10 seconds of black, and then that's the end of your commercial. So there you go. So you've got 20 key moments on here. You've got 7 seconds goes to black at 10 seconds or 10, not 10 seconds, well, it is 10 seconds, but 10 on the clock. It goes to picture start. Come down here. You go to 20, 30 and 40. Obviously, if it's a 30-second commercial, it just extends by 10 seconds. So that's it pretty much lined up. So you've got imagery between in those 20 seconds, and then you've got the tail end bit there. Audio is a bit different. What you need to do with audio, you need to have 6 frames of silence at the beginning and 6 frames of silence at the back. So you start here on there, Now you see I put the, in the bottom here, I put the audio in. Now the way I do it, if you watch the meters on the right hand side here, you have to be, I normally do it 6 seconds of silence, audio on the seventh. So you go, just tab it and you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 meters go up. That means your audio is coming on the seventh. And then you go to the back of the commercial onto 20 seconds and wait for the meters to drop. Now, it doesn't matter, you can finish early. I mean, I think I've done this on 8 seconds. So then we tab backwards, go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Maybe I think it's on a 7. There. So this is on 8 seconds back. But you can finish it early. I mean, it's, it, all it's about is so long as you are, you have 6 seconds of silence at the beginning, 6 at the end. You can do what you like in the middle. And that's it. So that is your audio actually technically lined up. That is a technically lined up commercial for broadcast. However, there's two bits that you've got to make sure your image is correct for broadcast. Now, you can do this in the setup on DaVinci Resolve. I don't trust it. I don't trust it, but you can. Where are you? Where are you? Color. In here, there's a thing that says TV safe somewhere. TV safe. It won't work in here, but there's a TV color management. There, make broadcast safe and the IRE levels. Now, I normally legalize, I get everything legalized. You send it to a, someone who can legalize it for you to make sure that it's in within broadcast tolerance. What it is so you don't get all the colors all over the place. So, you know, you get it legalized. That's the way to do it. You can do, there's online legalization. There's loads of ways to do it to get the picture legal. You get all sorts of weird and wonderful things. I mean, I don't have access to scopes to do the thing. But if you run it through a legalizer, it just does it for you. That's great. But I'm not 100% of the one that's in DaVinci Resolve. There you go. So, you know, then there's, that's the picture, but then there's the audio. Okay. Now, what I do, I send out the two stems. There's a voice on the top here, and then there's the audio, the music on the bottom. Now, do a rough mix so the client approves it. Send it off to the audio guy as an export, two WAV files. He does the mix and sends it back. But he also does something very important. Now, you can do it in here. You can do it in here. I didn't do this. I don't do it. But timeline, you've got this. Audio, where are you? AI tools, audio assistant. And what this does, you can select your delivery standard. So you need to be EBU R28. What that is, it's like a, it's minus 23 lufs or something. It's a continuous sound profile for the audio. So for me, I send it off to an audio guy, get it done. So I get it legalized externally and I get an audio guy to do my mix. But you can do it in here if you want to give it a, I've never tried that, but you'd mix it how you want it. Then you'd hit that button and let's just try it. Hopefully it won't destroy, won't destroy the OBS. Look at it, it's doing its thing. Oh, I'm not, yeah. So it's decided that's now legal for EBU 182. I don't know. Never put that into combat. All right, so you're pretty sus now. You've done it. You know, you'd obviously have done an edit. I've just dropped some clips in. And then you need to get it out the door. So let's give it a that. So come down the back here. And I'm not going to run down because I'll kill OBS. So here we go, just call it TVC. And there's obviously a naming convention. I always use the clock number on the commercial. Come down here, make sure you've got interlaced rendering and it's got to be upper field top, upper field first. Okay. And then make sure with your audio, you've got PCM 48, 24 bit. Now you should go out as ProRes and you have to go out as ProRes 422 HQ, not 422, 4HQ 422. And then I think that's it. And then you'd add that to the render queue and you'd render it. And then you've got your clip. So that's that bit done. So what I would do then, and I've rendered this time out already, let me clear out this. And then I'll bring a file browser and go into my video folder, videos, and it's timeline 2 render out. Now, you think you've done it, but you need to double check because the amount of times that something's gone wrong in the render and you know you've left a switch off or something like that. So what I've done in here, there's a brilliant little app and you can get it from the AUR and I think it's available on the Flatpak store. I mean, I swore by it for years just to have a look back at your file to make sure it's okay. So right click on this, open with, and it's called media info. You just click on that and here it is. So I want view and I want text. here's my commercial. So run it on Resolve. Codec ID is APCH, which stands for 422HQ. And this is where things go wrong with people rendering out with FFmpeg. There's metadata in here and QC can detect it. So that's why you need a legal, a proper, Apple ProRes renderer. So that's the one of the flags. Okay, and then you scroll down. It's 422, interlaced field, top field first. Apple, two channels of audio. Duration is 50 seconds dead. Anything else in there? And there's my matrix coefficients 2.4 or BT709. It can be if you've chosen 709A, but both will go. So that's fine. And there it is. Variable constant, bit mode, frame rate mode constant, 16 aspect ratio, 16 by 9. So there. So that's it. So you've created your commercial. Let me just go back to the other screen. And then we'll just go to this. So there you go. That's a lineup for a broadcast commercial. And, that's Linux. Free operating system. Yeah, you pay £300 for DaVinci Resolve. I have to say, like, Omarchy works really well for what I do in this. It's really, really good. But there you go. That's proper job done. That's as hard as it was. Unless you do DPP, or which is like major programming. I've not done one of those for a while. But, if you don't, that's a proper delivery for broadcast. So if you're cutting your videos for YouTube, if you're trying to adhere to certain standards, like broadcast standards, how you make stuff, like shoot at the highest resolution you can, check your colors. If you legalize your audio on there, it's got legalization for YouTube and it's got legalization for EBU 128. If you, work to a broadcast convention, you can't go wrong, because obviously YouTube sort of like, it's not at that level, is it? It's the wild west of what you can do with it. I could leave half the picture missing and no one's going to tell me off, are they? But when you learn to edit for broadcast, then you really know, you sort of really got a good handle on what you need to achieve to get a good picture. Anyway, there was a bizarre episode of my Linux thing, but I just thought it was interesting. I see so many people do demonstrations of Linux, installations of Linux. I do it, but and what it can do, but this is actually what it can do. It's because an operating system, as I've said before, it's just a utility. It's all about the software you use and making stuff with it, So I hope that's useful to somebody. And if you've got questions about that, or if I've done it wrong, let me know in the comments. Many thanks. And thanks for watching.